Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Let me show you a cool way to efficiently create plants and all kinds of vegetation for your Photoshop paintings. If you want a lot of details in your image, but you don't want to spend ages on drawing every single little leaf, then this is a great method for you. I created this image using the techniques I have shown previously on this channel. I modeled it in 3D and then I rendered it and painted on top of it. And I might show it, I might share a time lapse of how that was done. But the most fun part of this painting was to draw all the lush little plants. And I will show you now how that was done. In Photoshop, I will create a custom brush preset. Let's start by drawing a few leaves next to each other, like a small branch of leaves. I use the lasso tool for this because it gives me a clean edge, but you can draw it however you like, of course. I find that having a somewhat symmetrical layout of the leaves helps. Most of the time, my environmental paintings will have a camera that is sort of on the ground, or at least looking straight at the object. But you could also create a custom one for, let's say, a top view or something similar to that. So when I'm happy with my design, I select the area I want and then I go to Edit, Define Brush Preset. And that lets you name your brush. Let's call this one Branch. As you can see, you can now start painting with this newly created brush. But the way it comes out is, you know, defaultly it's not really what I'm after. So on the right hand side menu, you will find brush settings. Let's change some of these. First, we have brush tip shape. I will increase the spacing so that the count of leaves are not so high when I paint. Then under shape dynamics, I will adjust the size jitter. It will basically randomize the size of the brush. The angle jitter does the same, but for the rotation. And you want to keep that quite low. And then you can also tick the flip X jitter, which mirrors the brush horizontally, and that helps to take out repeating patterns. The final thing I will add is under color dynamics. So let's select a nice green color for my leaves. And then we can adjust the brightness jitter. I will put that around 5%. So now we can try out this new brush. Let's paint a bit here. I find that you would start by using a darker color and then adding highlights on top. That's a good approach because if you, let's say, draw a bush, you get darker shadows inside and then the further the leaves come out, you have brighter colors. Make sure not to paint it all with one color, but use different shades of green or whatever color you have selected. This technique applies to more than just leaves, of course. You can create clouds or all sorts of things with this method. Here I got a grass brush, for example. That helps to add details to the ground of my paintings. Painting on white feels a bit strange here, so let's look at how I used the brush for the painting I did. You can see me using a grass brush to soften up the hard geometric shapes that came out of the 3D render. And then I used a leaf brush, similar to the one we just created, to paint in the vines that cling onto the wooden pergola. I've made a large library of brushes to stay away from too much repetitiveness. And here is the final image with all the lush little plants. Hope this was useful. Let me know so by hitting the like button below. Also subscribe to the channel, of course, for future videos. Have a good day, and I will see you in the next one.